Hey everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Dungeon Hack Redux. I'm Duke of the Bump, the level 6 cleric, and we are on level 4. I'd say this run is still going pretty well. We haven't run into any major catastrophes yet. Those bugbears were a little tough, but I think... Man, I just need to find a better weapon. I don't think this flame blade is going to be good enough down here. Maybe I should try spiritual hammer for a while. I heard that, I read that it gets more powerful as you level up. It's scaled with your level. So maybe I should give it a try and see if I have better luck than with flame blade. Let's see, is there anything else I want to change about my spells right now? Prayer. Okay. Yeah, this all looks good. Alright, so let's give it a try. The nice thing about Spiritual Hammer is that you can actually remove it from your hand. So if there's something else I want to do with this hand, then I can, I can just set this down on the ground. Oh, it's a Spiritual Hammer plus one. I wonder if the plus one is indicative of, whoa. Is that a shadow? I don't know what that was. Oops. Can't memorize spells. Of course not. I'm not a wizard. That was a shade wizard. I don't know what those guys do, actually. Wow. I did not encounter shade wizards at all during my practice run. I'm starting to... My arms feel like dead weights. What? Wait. My arms don't feel so heavy anymore. Oh, so these guys... Oh, no. These guys affect your strength. Restoration. I don't know what that does. Crap. That better just be a temporary effect. Because, man, if that permanently drains your strength, I'm screwed. I don't know what to do about that. I should post a note. Re-equip your shield. Don't punch. Okay. Wait. It was 15 a second ago, right? Is it still going down? This doesn't look good. That I really hope that's just a temporary thing. It has to be, right? There's no way they would screw you over permanently like that. I thought the only permanent effect, I thought, was the level drain. Speaking of level drain, oh my god. Loses one level of experience in all spells. Oh, it just means I have to re-memorize or re-pray for my spells. I didn't even know that was either a wraith or a white. I'm pretty sure. I think those are the only things that can drain your levels. Crap. Oh my god, my strength is 4? Okay, I need to rest and get my spells back. Crap. Maybe I should just abandon this run. Oh god, I don't want to do that though. Alright. Hopefully, I'm still... is that an entire level? Or do I need to get an entire level's worth of experience to get back to level 6? Or did it just knock me down a little bit below the experience that I need for 6. I don't know. Man, this is starting to get... Alright, well, okay. Let's rest and see what happens to my strength before I do anything else. Spiritual Hammer. And Aid. Alright. Oh yeah, I only have 2 of these now. Crap. Okay. I'll get a prayer and a negative plane protection, I guess. Well, my strength was slowly going back up, but it's still only 11. Man. There was that Shade Wizard thing that did that, right? I don't know. It looked like I wasn't really close to it when that happened. I guess I should go on ahead and cast all my buffs too. I don't know how long negative flame protection lasts. I might want to get two of those instead of one in a prayer. See, my strength was 10, and it must be an effect like the spiders or something. I don't think the Shade Wizard is what's causing that. So I just need to get out of that location. Is there a spell that can counteract weakness? I don't think it's a form of paralysis. Maybe dispel magic? But I think that just dispels whatever magic is. Like, if I cast that, whatever item in my other hand, the magic would be removed from it. I don't think it's a curse. I don't think it's a poison. Maybe protection from evil, but I don't know. I know one thing. Praying sure didn't help. Thanks a lot, God. Right when I need you. Oh, man. Wait, did I kill that thing? Yeah, okay, that was a white. Alright. I'm gonna continue. I was going to call it quits if I lost levels. But I don't want to do that so close to the beginning of the video. I guess I could just quit and continue with this video, but I kind of wanted to, you know, if I die, I wanted that to be like my, you know, the end of that video. Well, the spiritual hammer does seem to be doing a little bit better than the flame blade was, even with my reduced strength. So that's one silver lining, I guess. Or maybe these things are just easier to hit than the bugbears. Maybe that's the trade-off. Okay, so I didn't need to kill that many more monsters to hit level 6. So I should be okay, I think. As long as I don't lose any more levels. Let's get another negative plane protection. And I'll keep the prayer. I should probably look up the distinction between bless and prayer. Make sure that prayer is a total replacement for bless. Okay. I think this run is still salvageable. I'm liking the direction that using the spiritual hammer is taking me. It's kind of a bummer that my strength is so boned, but I'll try to work around it. Actually, you know, now that I think of it, thrown weapons might use dexterity instead of strength. I know, like, bows and stuff use dexterity as your primary attack stat. At least that's how it is in 4th edition. See, I've played 2nd edition D&D, the tabletop game, but it was a long time ago, and I didn't play nearly as much as I played 4th edition. Oh, crap. Oh, does that just protect me against one hit? Or does it really last that small amount of time? Oh, did I get him? I guess I got him. But yeah, the reason I'm more knowledgeable about 4th edition is because A, I played it a lot more recently, and B, I've played it a lot more because I have a friend who, well, a family member, but also a friend who basically, you know, got me into it. And for a while, I had like a bi-weekly D&D game going, like a regular, you know, like a real nerd. And I haven't played in a while because, I don't know, I got a little burned out on it. But, people have some opinions about what version of D&D is the best, and there are a lot of people who don't like 4th edition. I think 4th edition is a really great combat simulator. I don't know if it's a great role-playing game. I mean, really, it depends on the dungeon master and the players. Our sessions tended not to have a lot of actual role-playing, which I guess I kind of prefer that way because I'm really bad at, you know, role-playing and acting and improvising and all that. And the combat was really fun for a while. It's like very tactical, grid-based combat. Kind of like a, you know, it's more like a Shining Force or Final Fantasy Tactics or something than what you would normally think of as D&D. When you think of just guys sitting around a table using... Wow, I'm leveling up fast. Sitting around a table using their imaginations. There was like a grid-based map on the table. You had a miniature to represent you. And it was really fun combat. The problem was it took 8 hours to play, you know, one combat encounter. And it can drain you. Alright, what am I doing? Oh, yeah. Check out my... Okay, I have level 4 spells now. Awesome. I guess you don't get more of the lower level spells as you level up, just higher level spells. Blessed Warmth. Okay, I need to look that up and see what that does. Cure Serious Wounds. We have Neutralized Poison now. That'll probably come in handy. I think for now, I'll take Cure Serious Wounds. Not sure what Free Action does. Oh, I think that lets you move freely underwater, if I remember what I read correctly. Blessed Warmth might just be like a better version of Bless and Prayer. The rest of these are pretty self-explanatory. Okay. But yeah, I think 4th edition would work a lot better as a video game. And I'm kind of bummed out that they haven't used 4th edition as the basis for a video game yet. Because if you automated all that stuff, man, that would be just really great, fun combat. Okay, well, I'm slowly making progress. My strength's back to normal now. Great, thank God. I was really scared for a while. But let's see, why did I start talking? Oh yeah, in 4th edition, your attack is based on either your strength or dexterity, whether you're using melee or ranged weapons. Like, a sword is strength, and a bow and arrow would be dexterity. But I forget what thrown weapons are classified as. It could be either. Okay, so yeah, negative plane protection is definitely just good for one hit, because I just got hit... Oops. I just got hit by that thing, and it expired. So, recast that. Okay, definitely glad I switched to the hammer. This is working out a lot better for me than the flame blade was. Oh, I don't have a helmet yet. That's nice. I'll go ahead and put it on, and if it's cursed, I'll just pray for remove curse. Okay, it's not cursed. Armor class 4. Armor class 1. Nice. That's a pretty good improvement. Don't think I'll use a staff for anything. I need to find another enemy to figure out what this wand does. I mean, I could just cast it, but I wouldn't want to waste a charge. Let's see what these bells do. It might be the bells of unlocking. I'm curious. It's bad to be curious in this game. I probably shouldn't do this, but. Suddenly I'm famished. Oh, so that's the cursed chimes. They make you hungry. Very weird. How many rations do I left? Is that my last one? Wow. Okay, well, I do have create food and water, so I don't have to panic. Of course, ideally, a book. The easiest way to die immediately in this game is to read an unidentified book, because there's a very good chance if you read a book that it'll just drive you insane and it's game over. That's a wand of lightning, which is nice. Did I ever figure out what this wand did? I don't think so. Okay, well, first things first, I need to recast negative plane protection, which I don't currently have, so let's pray for spells. Gotta start getting create food and water, sadly. Which means, man, I'm gonna have to do a lot of resting to keep all my buffs going. So I'll take one of those. Of course, the nice thing about create food and water is that it fills you up all the way. So once I cast it, I won't have to cast it for a while. All right, rest. Break camp. Create food and water. Thank you, God. Negative plane protection. Prayer. Spiritual hammer. Aid my kingdom for a hotbar. Figure out what this balsa wand does, if anything, and then switch back to my shield. Or rest again and get another negative plane protection because I got hit by another white. But yeah, I mean, okay, I've used all the charges, so apparently this wand did nothing. Hey, don't magic missile me, jerk. Alright, I can forget about that wand. Switch back to my shield. But now that I have the helmet, ooh, my armor class is -1. It's even better. Of course, I don't think it helps against these magical attacks. But it'll be nice once I start running into more heavy hitters. Not these spellcasters. God, that guy just did 10 points of damage to me. Alright, spiritual hammer. Very good choice. They're scared of me. They close the door. You can't get away from me that easily. Are these things teleporting? I'm not killing them that easily, am I? Sorry, I bumped my pop filter trying to scratch my nose. There might have been a donk there. I think I'm just a badass with this thing. I'm killing those whites in one hit. Well, sometimes. Not all the time. Also, I'm a little worried about that sound. That whooshing sound. It sounds like teleporting. I'm not 100% sure, though. I know these whites can't teleport, so I'm not worried about them. Bracers? Journal page? Spoiler alert, drinking a potion of confusion confuses you. I know, right? Maybe that sound is just them casting the magic missiles. The really sad thing about 4th edition is that I don't think there's ever going to be a video game based on it. Because that doesn't seem to be what Wizards of the Coast is interested in. They have their MMO, D&D Online, if that thing's even still going. And they have, like, that free-to-play Facebook game, which was pretty bad. There's like, a real proper Neverwinter game coming out, or there was supposed to be, wasn't there? I think I remember hearing something about that. I don't think they're going to make like a proper turn-based D&D game ever again. There really haven't been that many turn-based D&D games. There was Temple of Elemental Evil, which was interesting the brief amount of time that I played it, but it was very difficult. I bet there's a secret passage in this hallway somewhere, because there's a big wide open space here. Yeah, I mean, I'd love a video game based on 4th edition. You know who I want to make it? Firaxis. The people who did the XCOM reboot. Aha! I bet they would be able to make a hell of a 4th edition D&D game. I haven't even played XCOM yet. I need to. That game seems right up my alley. I love turn-based strategy games. I haven't played it yet because I'm intimidated by it. The name XCOM summons mental images of crushing, punishing difficulty. But it's definitely on my list. I own it. I bought it during a Steam sale a while back. Actually, I bought it during a Green Man Gaming sale. And I bought it very... It was a very affordable price. Alright, well, let's check out that Cure Serious Wound spell. See just how serious it is. Seems like that could have been more serious. Seems pretty similar to Cure Light Wounds, to be honest. Maybe I just got really terrible rolls on both of those. Sometimes the dice just aren't in your favor. But yeah, I'm sure if I actually, like, forced myself to play XCOM, I'd really like it. I mean, this game is probably harder than XCOM. There aren't many games in recent years that can compare to the difficulty of a computer role-playing game from 1993. I figure Dark Souls probably comes pretty close. That's like the closest equivalent we have to a super punishing 90s RPG. Alright, so that was my negative plane protection. So it looks like it lasts a pretty long time. Uh-oh. I forgot that doesn't pause it. Seems like it lasts a pretty long time as long as you don't get hit. Which is good. But... Oh. I have one that I didn't have allocated. That's weird. Alright, well, let's get another negative plane protection then. And I don't need to create food and water at the moment, so... I'll get three of those. That seems to be an important spell to have right now. And I have another one of these. Oh, I guess I leveled up again and I didn't even realize it. Or maybe that was the one that just happened so quickly that I didn't get to react to it yet. Okay, well, let's get another Cure Serious Wounds, I guess. Until I have a chance to look at what Blessed Warmth does. I think free action is just underwater movement, so that's probably nothing that important. Alright, let's do the routine. Spiritual Hammer. It's a good thing I got that spell first. Okay, buddy. You're being really impetuous at the moment. Maybe negative plane protection just lasts until you get hit. That would be pretty convenient. Prayer. Okay, where was I going? Oh, yeah. Man, it's a shame. It's a shame the screen wasn't like 100 pixels higher. So this arrow wouldn't even be necessary to bump it up like a few pixels. I could print it out. I bet that works in DOSBox. It's kind of weird. This game runs, the native resolution in this game is 300 or 320 by 200. Which is very odd. It's like a slightly more widescreen than standard DOS programs. Because most of them are 320 by 240. At least that's like, I don't know, VGA resolution or something like that. It's a very non-standard resolution. Uh-oh. Okay. For a second it looked like my hammer wasn't coming back to me. So yeah, if it just ran in 320 by 240, like every other program, then you'd fit the entire map on the screen. I should probably try to sidestep those magic missiles more. I should probably do more sidestepping in general. Oh, while I'm here, oh yeah, do I still not have the feather? Guess not. It's probably in this room somewhere. Uh-oh. Alright, I was freaking out a little bit at the beginning of this video. Punch you while my hammer's in the air. But I think I'm okay. Negative plane protection is working out for me. My strength is back. It was just that one hallway. For whatever reason, there was like a strength draining trap. Oh man. Well, I've been every obvious place and I still haven't found the feather. So I guess I better start looking for illusionary walls. Unless I missed the feather somewhere. I really hope there's not like an alcove on the wall that had it that I just missed because I wasn't paying attention. Oh yeah. That was a room I just did. Hopefully, I didn't miss something obvious. And you're all screaming at your computer monitors or your televisions. Does anyone else watch LPs on a like an actual large television? Cause I do, and it's pretty freaking awesome. Like, I don't know, do most of the popular like Rokus and Apple TVs and all that, do those support YouTube? Cause I just do it the old fashioned way. I have my computer hooked up to my TV. Because, you know, I live alone, and anytime I'm watching something on my TV, it's coming off of my computer. I bet the secret passage is over here somewhere. So I can actually do that. I know a lot of people, like, live with other people who use the TV, so they can just keep it hooked up all the time like I do. But still, it's a great way to watch LPs. Probably my favorite way to relax is to put on an oh man, it's that damn strength draining hallway. Is to put on an LP or a stream, sit on the couch, and play stuff on my DS. It's a great way to unwind. You know, just put a game on in the background, someone I enjoy listening to, and just kind of unwind. I know the feather is on this level somewhere because I turned off multi-level puzzles. I'm still not really looking at the walls. See, this is a situation where I hate the fact that that enemies respawn because I just want to look around and find the feather or find the secret passage. And with enemies constantly respawning, I have to worry about those as well. It's kind of like when you're playing a JRPG with way too many random encounters and you're just trying to figure out where the hell you need to go, but you keep getting into fights over and over again. It's kind of like that. There aren't many enemies nearby at the moment though, knock on wood. Hopefully they stay away for a bit. And I definitely don't have the feather in my inventory, right? I don't. I kind of wish I knew what that book did, because if it doesn't drive you insane, there's a good chance that it'll permanently increase one of your stats. So it's a very good risk versus reward kind of proposition. However, it is quite a risk. Of course, if you're not playing, you know, Iron Man like I am, then all you have to do is save right before you read a book. But something seems to be missing here. Yeah, no shit. I don't know where the feather could be, and I don't know where the secret passage could be. I mean, this is all, these blue dots are all just crap, right? There's like a sling and a used up wand laying on the ground. I should probably double check each of these blue dots and make sure none of them are the feather. I don't see how I could have missed it, though. Alright, that was... I already forget. I know it wasn't the feather, though, because I was just there. Alright. I'm gonna just pick up all of these just to make absolutely sure that I get everything lay on the ground. And then once I find what I'm looking for, I can start getting rid of some of this clutter. Alright, that's a staff. No reason for me to hold on to that, but I'll do that until I'm positive that I'm not missing something obvious. Wait. Oh, nope. It's an alcove, but it's empty. Or a niche in the language of this video game. Is it niche or niche? Oh, there's a healing machine here. I might as well go on ahead and use this since I have all these silver coins. I know a niche is like... I know niche is how you pronounce it when you're like talking about your role in society or something. Like, I need to find my niche, but I don't know if it's the same word. Alright, so the only blue dot left is that, and that's definitely not the feather. So let's look around for more secret passages, I guess. Need to stop looking at my map all the time. If it's just an alcove in the wall that has it, then I'm going to feel very, very silly. I probably walked past it numerous times. But the problem is, if I'm not looking at my map, then I don't know where the heck I'm going, because everything looks the same. Come on, hammer. Thank you. See, that's the nice thing about the hammer. It has two chances to hit everything, once on the way there and once on the way back, if it missed it the first time around. Alright, so that wasn't a secret passage. I mean, I think I've checked every wall, haven't I? Every wall that could be a secret passage. Or every wall that could be a useful secret passage, I guess. Wait. Oh, it was just that my arms feel heavy message. I'm sorry, I know this is incredibly entertaining, but I'm actually kind of stumped. Alright, I checked all of these. Wait, oh. I bet it's right there. How much do you want to bet? I didn't even think to check there. But the thing about this map generator is that it likes to cover every available square on the map with something. So how much do you want to bet? Okay. Well, it was a secret passage, but there's no damn feather. No ding dong dang damn feather. Right, is there anywhere else I could have a secret passage? I've checked all of these walls. I've checked all of these. I've checked here. Alright. If it's not a secret passage, it has to be on the wall somewhere. Or in the wall, rather. So I just need to... I just need to look at every single part of the wall very carefully. Man, that's really annoying if that's the case. It's Oh wait, I meant to pick up that staff. Just so I don't have that blue spot on. Hey! I was shuffling my inventory around, thank you very much. Just so I don't have that blue spot taunting me. It's like, hey, here's an item. Maybe it's a feather. That doesn't seem to do anything. Huh, weird. That doesn't seem to do anything. Weird. Maybe I should just attack it. Maybe I should put a rock there. This video has gone on entirely too long. If this is like a glitch or something, then I'm going to be a very, very upset Duke of the Bump. I'm going to have to pass a decree of some sort. I don't know what kind of decree. I just know it has to be a decree. Alright, that's like the edge of the map, right? Yeah. Alright, there are no other spots where a secret passage could be. I've checked everywhere. So it has to be in the wall. And on the plus side, I have all the time in the world, technically, because if I start running out of food, I'll just get crave food and water again. I'm not looking at the map. I'm looking at where I'm going. I'm looking at the walls for any sort of indentation. There's an indentation, but there's nothing there. There's that secret passage that led nowhere. Thanks a lot. Really appreciate that. Maybe the monsters. I don't know. I'm not sure how the game handles respawning. The respawning of monsters. But I seem to have cleared out a good portion of them. I need to go back through here and check all of these walls. Unless I already checked them and don't remember. Man, it's really shitty that if keys can spawn in the wall alcoves like that. If that's even what's going on here. I mean, that's the only theory I have. Aw, man. I sidestepped right into the dang magic missiles. I mean, it's either that or a glitch. There's no other explanation. I've checked everywhere there could be a secret passage. Unless I'm wrong. It's happened a few times. George is getting frustrated. And by George, I mean Duke. And by Duke, I mean me. Duke's not my real name, but that's what people call me. Because of a totally arbitrary, dumb internet name I picked for myself one fateful day in 2007. Boy, you don't really think this far ahead when you pick your internet name. It's like, oh, Duke of the Bum, that's kind of funny. It's like King of the Hill, but not as good. LOL. And now, 2014, 7 years later, and I'm stuck with it. Right, I was looking at my map when I shouldn't have been. Even though I'm pretty sure I've explored everywhere around here. If it was around here, I would have found it by now, right? This has been going 40 minutes. I bet my strength is like zero now, yeah, because I keep walking through this area. Well, I mean, it's three, but it might as well be zero. I'm thinking of cutting it here. I hate cutting it when I'm not at some sort of milestone. But I can't do this much longer. Not on camera, anyway. Not on candy camera. That's what it feels like I'm on. Like I'm having some sort of cruel practical joke played on me. Smile. You're on candy camera. I'm sorry I'm not giving the hilarious reality TV reaction to this. I mean, I could go full angry video game nerd on it. But that's not really my style. Not anymore, anyway. I went through a phase where I tried to emulate the angry video game nerd. And that phase was called Splatterhouse 2. Alright. I'm sorry, guys. I'm gonna cut it here. And then... I mean, it's practically the end of the level. All I have to do is find that feather and unlock that door. And the exit has to be right behind that... Well, okay, not right behind that door, but somewhere in that general area. So, yeah. Tune in tomorrow for more Dungeon Hack. Hopefully, I can figure this thing out off-camera and not go totally crazy trying to figure out what to do. If any of you have any suggestions, well, I would say leave them in the comments, but I'll probably have figured it out by then since I'm recording these in advance. But yeah, I don't know what tomorrow will bring. Tune in then and find out. Goodbye.